There are countless stars that we can see in our night sky, and all of them are unique. Some are dim such that they are barely visible without a telescope. Others are bright and can seem even in the most light-polluted areas. The brightness of a star depends on its composition and its location relative to our planet. Astronomers define star brightness in terms of apparent magnitude, which is how bright the star appears from Earth, and absolute magnitude, which is how the star appears at a standard distance of 32.6 light years, that is equivalent to 10 parsecs. In addition to this, astronomers measure a star's luminosity, which is the amount of energy that a star emits from its surface. Measuring a star's brightness is an ancient procedure. However, today's astronomers use more precise tools and equipment to obtain their measurements. Curious to know the brightest stars in the sky? Keep watching. The brightness of stars is measured using the magnitude scale, which seems a little backwards. Since the lower number, the brighter the object is, and the higher number, the dimmer it is. The scale is logarithmic and set so that every 5 steps equals a 100 times decrease in brightness. So magnitude 10 is 100 times dimmer than magnitude 5, which in turn is 100 times dimmer than magnitude 0. More than 2,000 years ago, the Greek astronomer Hipparchus was the first to categorize the stars according to their brightness. Basically, he looked at the stars in the sky and classified them by how bright they appear. The brightest stars were of magnitude 1, the next brightest were of magnitude 2, and so on down to magnitude 6, which were the faintest stars he could observe. Human eyes, however, are not very discerning, since large differences in brightness actually appear much smaller using this scale. Therefore, light-sensitive, charged-coupled devices inside digital cameras measure the amount of light coming from stars and can provide a more precise definition of brightness. Using the scale magnitude, astronomers now define 5 magnitudes difference as having a brightness ratio of 100. Vega was used as the reference star for the scale. Initially, it had a magnitude of 0, but more precise measurements changed that to 0.3. When taking Earth as a reference point, the scale magnitude fails to account for the true differences in brightness, or apparent magnitude, depending on the location of the observer. Different observers will come up with a different measurement depending on their locations and distance from the star. Stars that are closer to Earth but fainter could appear brighter than far more luminous ones that are far away. Therefore, it is useful to establish a convention whereby we can compare 2 stars on the same footing without variations in brightness due to different distances complicating the issue. A solution to these variations was to implement an absolute magnitude scale to provide a reference between stars. To do so, astronomers calculate the brightness of stars as they would appear 32.6 light years or 10 parsecs from Earth. Another brightness is luminosity, which is defined in the introduction. It's usually expressed in watts and measured in terms of the luminosity of the sun, or the solar luminosity, which is approximately 3.827 times 10 to the power 26 watts, and one of the oldest stars to Earth, Alpha Centauri A, is about 1.3 times the solar luminosity. To figure out luminosity from absolute magnitude, one must calculate that a difference of 5 on the absolute magnitude scale is equivalent to a factor of 100 on the luminosity scale. For instance, a star with an absolute magnitude of 1 is 100 times as luminous as a star with an absolute magnitude of 6. While the absolute magnitude scale is astronomers' best effort to compare the brightness of stars, there are a couple of main limitations that have to do with the instruments that are used to measure it. First, astronomers must define which wavelength of light they are using to make the measurement. Stars can emit radiation in forms ranging from high-energy X-rays to low-energy infrared radiation. Depending on the type of star, they could be bright in some of these wavelengths and dimmer in others. To address this, scientists must specify which wavelength they are using to make the absolute magnitude measurements. Another key limitation is the sensitivity of the instrument used to make the measurement. In general, as computers have advanced and telescope mirror technology has improved over the years, measurements that are made in recent years have more weight among scientists than those that are made long ago. Paradoxically, the brightest stars are among the least studied by astronomers. but there is at least one recent effort to catalog their luminosity. A constellation of satellites called BRIGHT, Bright Target Explorer, will measure the variability of brightness between stars. Participants in the six-satellite project include Austria, Canada, and Poland, the first two satellites launched successfully in 2013. While many stars have a consistent brightness, there are more than 100,000 known and cataloged variable stars. Even our own Sun is variable, varying its energy output by about 0.1%, or 1,000th of its magnitude, during its 11-year solar cycle. Variable stars are either intrinsic, meaning their luminosity changes due to features such as expansion, contraction, eruption, or pulsation, or extrinsic, meaning that a star or planet passes in front of the star and blocks the light, or that the change is due to stellar rotation. Stars can also change in luminosity over time. The North Star, or Polaris for example, could have been as much as 4.6 times brighter in ancient times than it is today. A 2014 study noted that the star dimmed for the past few decades, but then drastically brightened again. Polaris is part of the class of Cepheid variables, which are extremely luminous stars that have short pulsation periods. The variations in the luminosity allow astronomers to calculate how far away these Cepheids are, making them useful measuring sticks if the stars are embedded in galaxies or nebula. Other types of intrinsic variable stars include cataclysmic variables, which brighten due to outbursts, such as during supernova explosions, or eruptive variables, whose brightness varies during eruptions on the surface, or combinations with interstellar matter. Extrinsic variables include eclipsing binary stars and rotating stars, such as pulsars, the cores of supernova whose electromagnetic radiation is only visible when the beam is directed at Earth. Before listing the brightest stars in the universe, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. From our corner of the galaxy, these stars are the most brilliant signposts in the heavens and can be enjoyed even from the light-polluted hearts of major cities. Number 1. Sirius. All stars shine, but none do it like Sirius, the brightest star in the night sky. Aptly named Sirius comes from the Greek word cirrus, meaning searing or scorching. Blazing at a magnitude of -1.42, it's twice as bright as any star in our sky besides the Sun. Sirius resides in the constellation of Canis Major, the Big Dog, and is commonly called the Dog Star. In ancient Greece, the dawn rising of Sirius marked the hottest part of summer, the season's dog days. Sirius no longer marks the hottest part of summer because it now rises later in the year. This happens because the Earth has been wobbling slowly around its axis in a 25,800-year cycle. This wobble, called precession, is caused by the gravitational attraction of the Moon on Earth's equatorial bulge, and it gradually changes the location of stars on the celestial sphere. The best time to see Sirius is probably in winter for Northern Hemisphere observers, because it rises fairly early in the evening. In 1844, the German astronomer Friedrich Bessel observed that Sirius had a wobble, as if it were being tugged by a companion star. And in 1862, Alvin Clark solved this mystery while testing his new 18.5-inch lens, the largest refracting telescope in the world at that time. Clark discovered that Sirius was not one star, but two. This proved to be the first discovery in what became a whole class of stars, the compact stellar remnant, or white dwarf. These are stars that, once depleting all their oxygen, collapse to a very dense core. Astronomers have calculated that Sirius's companion, dubbed Sirius B, contains the mass of the Sun in a package as small as the Earth. 16 millimeters of matter from Sirius B, that is about 1 cubic inch of the stuff, would weigh 2,000 kilograms on Earth. At magnitude 8.5, it is 1/400th as luminous as the Sun. The brighter and larger companion is now known as Sirius A. Number 2. Canopus. Canopus resides in the constellation Carina, the Keel. Carina is one of three modern-day constellations that once formed the ancient constellation of Argo Navis, named for the ship Jason and the Argonauts sailed in search for the Golden Fleece. Two other constellations form the sail, Vela and the stern Puppis. In modern odysseys, spacecraft like Voyager 2 use the light from Canopus to orient themselves in the sea of space. Canopus is a true powerhouse. Its brilliance is due more to its great luminosity than its proximity. This number 2 on our list of stars has 14,800 times the intrinsic luminosity of the Sun, but at 316 light-years away, it's more than 37 times as far from us as the number 1 star Sirius. With a magnitude of -0.72, Canopus is easy to find in the night sky, though it is only visible at latitudes south of 37 degrees north. Number 3. Alpha Centauri. Alpha Centauri, or Rigel Centaurus, as it is also known, is actually a system of 3 stars gravitationally bound together. The 2 main stars are Alpha Centauri A and Alpha Centauri B. The tiniest star in the system is Alpha Centauri C, a red dwarf. The Alpha Centauri system is a special one. At an average distance from us of 4.3 light years, these stars are our nearest known stellar neighbors. Centauri A and Centauri B are remarkably sun-like, with Centauri A a near twin of the Sun. Both are yellow G stars. In comparison to the Sun, Alpha Centauri A is 1.5 times as luminous and shines at a magnitude of -0.01, while Alpha Centauri B is half as luminous and shines at a magnitude of 1.3. Alpha Centauri C is 1/7,000th as bright and shines at 11th magnitude. Of the 3 stars, the smallest is the closest to the Sun, 4.22 light-years away. Because of its proximity, it is known as Proxima Centauri. When night falls and the skies are clear in the summer, the Alpha Centauri system shines at a magnitude of -0.27, low in the southern sky. You can find it at the foot of the Centaur in the constellation Centaurus. Number 4. Arcturus. Arcturus is the brightest star in the northern celestial hemisphere. The first 3 stars on this list are actually in the southern celestial sphere, though seasonally they are visible from the northern hemisphere of Earth. Known as the Bear Watcher, Arcturus follows Ursa Major, the Great Bear, around the north celestial pole. The name itself derives from the Greek word arctos, meaning bear. Arcturus is an orange giant, twice as massive and 215 times as bright as the Sun. It takes 37 years for the light of Arcturus to reach us, so when we gaze upon it, we are seeing the star as it looked 37 years ago. It glows at a magnitude of -0.04 in our night sky. A variable star, Arcturus is in the last stages of life. During its internal struggle between gravity and pressure, Arcturus has swelled to 25 times the Sun's diameter. Number 5. Vega. The name Vega comes from the Arabic word for swooping eagle or vulture. Vega is the luminary of Lyra, the Harp, a small but prominent constellation that is home to the ring nebula M57 and the star Epsilon Lyrae. The ring is a luminous shell of gas resembling a smoke ring or a donut that was ejected from an old star. Epsilon Lyrae appears to the naked eye as a double star, but through a small telescope you can see that each of the 2 individual stars is itself a double. Epsilon Lyrae is popularly known as the double-double. Vega is a hydrogen-burning dwarf star 54 times as luminous and 1.5 times as massive as the Sun. At 25 light-years away, it is relatively close to us, shining with a magnitude of 0.03 in the night sky. Number 6. Capella. Capella is the primary star in the constellation Auriga, the Charioteer, and the brightest star near to the north celestial pole. Capella is actually a fascinating star system of 4 stars, 2 similar class G yellow giant stars and a pair of much fainter red dwarf stars. The brighter yellow giant known as AA is 80 times as luminous and nearly 3 times as massive as the Sun. The fainter yellow giant known as AB is 50 times as luminous as the Sun and 2.5 times as massive. The combined luminosity of the 2 stars is the equivalent of about 130 suns. The Capella system is 42 light years away, its light reaching us with a magnitude of 0.08. Number 7. Rigel. On the western heel of Orion, the Hunter, rests brilliant Rigel. In myth, Rigel marks the spot where Scorpio, the Scorpion, stung Orion after a brief but fierce battle. Its Arabic name means the foot. Rigel is a multiple star system. The brighter component, Rigel A, is a blue supergiant, that shines a remarkable 40,000 times stronger than the Sun. Although it's 775 light-years distant, its light shines bright in our evening skies at a magnitude of 0.12. Number 8. Procyon. Procyon resides in the small constellation of Canis Minor, the little dog. The constellation symbolizes the smaller of Orion's two hunting dogs. The other is, of course, Canis Major. The word Procyon is Greek for before the dog. For in the northern hemisphere, Procyon announces the rise of Sirius, the dog star. Procyon is a yellow-white main sequence star, twice the size and seven times as luminous as the Sun. Like Alpha Centauri, it appears so bright because at 11.4 light-years, it is relatively close. Number 9. Akrinar. Akrinar is derived from the Arabic phrase meaning the end of the river, an appropriate name for a star that marks the southernmost flow of the constellation Eridanus. The river, Akrinar, is the hottest star on this list. Its temperature has been measured to be between 13,000 and 19,000 degrees Celsius. Its luminosity ranges from 2,900 to 5,400 times that of the Sun. Shining at a magnitude of 0.45, its light takes 144 years to reach your eye. Number 10. Betelgeuse. Don't let Betelgeuse's ranking as the 10th brightest star in the sky fool you. Its distance, 430 light-years, hides the true scale of this supergiant. With a whopping luminosity of 55,000 suns, Betelgeuse still shines bright in our skies at a magnitude of 0.5. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you learn anything new in this video? Can you guess another procedure by which we can measure a star's brightness? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.